Hi everyone, today I'm gonna show you how to configure Apache web server in Linux. At first, we have to install httpd if it's not installed. We can see system status httpd that the service is not on the system, so we have to install it through the command yum install httpd. We confirm the installation. As soon as the installation is completed, there are a few steps that we have to take. First, we have to enable HTTP into the firewall service list. If we want to add the HTTP service, we have to run the command firewall command manager list service. This command will show us all the service enabled through firewall. As you can see right now, HTTP is not enabled. So if we want to enable it, we have to run the command firewall cmd add service equals HTTP. To see if the service was added, we run the command list service. To enable the new configuration, we have to restart the firewall.service. Second step, we enable the httpd service. At first, we run the command system ctl status httpd and the service is down. We have to enable it, and we enable it through the command system ctl enable httpd dash dash now. This will start and enable the service. To verify, we run the command system ctl status httpd. If we want to take a look inside the configuration file for httpd service, we can use or command cat or command vim if we want to modify, going through this path. I want to take a deep look inside this configuration file just to let you see the default directory that is set for all the file that will be retrieved by httpd service. In future I will do a video of how to change the default directory and also how to deal with clinux. Let's create an index file just for an example. We use the command vim and we place the file inside the default path directory for httpd. We will call it index.html and we will write inside a sample text. One thing that we have to ensure is that this file has the read permission for all the users. Let's verify it. In this video, I will use Elinx, that is a web-based browser inside the console that you can run in a very simple way. If you want to enable it, you have to run the command subscription manager repo dash dash enable, and after this you have to place the name of the repo. Finally, if we run the command elinx http localhost we will retrieve the index page. As you can see, this is the page that we created before, and now it's running into the server, into the machine. If you enjoy the video, subscribe in the channel. In future, I will follow these two main playlists, configuration and connection setup, but in future I will also publish video related to security stuff more in deep, in a deepest way. And see you in the future.